you would think.
Yeah, I think that's what's going to happen. And once that's over, she can do all kinds of stuff. There's books, there's lectures, there's all kinds of things she can do other than run for office again. And I think by that time too, the Democrats may have grown weary of Hillary Clinton, and not out of meanness, but just weary. And so maybe somebody else's chance to step into the arena and go up against Obama.
All right, so it's the economy, the issue with Gitmo. What are some other things out there that you think that he should really address in the next few years? I mean, there's a lot of people that are talking about the tone of the country, the sense of personal responsibility in the nation, the sense of certainly the urban agenda
Right.
might be out there. Is there other things out there that you see?
Well, you touched on it when you spoke of the urban agenda, and I think of education. And I think that is an area that President Obama is going to really have to come down hard on in terms of, in this country, when it comes to education, this country is really weird. I mean, there are people who believe that the best education is the private education that you have to pay money for, and that the public education, which is something, one of the few things that I think government really has to be responsible for, just is not as good as it should be. And a lot of times they're right, because there's so many other elements involved in education that has really slowed it down. You have the No Child Left Behind Act, where the idea was to focus on scores. And if the scores go up, that means the kids are smarter. But too many schools are teaching for the test now. And so instead of learning as they should, knowledge and kind of going along, it becomes more like, okay, well, look, we got to study for this test and make sure you get A, B, and C, D right. Because if you don't do well, our scores drop, we lose our funding, and all heck breaks loose. On the other end, there is the rise of charter schools. These are schools that have kind of can do their own thing in a way, away from the public sector, although they still get public money. There's been a great increase in that, but also they need a little bit of policing as well. I mean, some of the charter schools, as we found out in Philadelphia, the folks who run them have basically scammed the taxpayers.
We're seeing a considerable problem with that.
Yeah. And I think that's because education seems to be something that people want somebody else to take care of. Like they don't, if they can pay somebody money to teach their kid, instead of having to rely on the government to teach their kid or the city to teach their kid, they're going to do that. They want to do that. And I think there are a lot of scammers who've taken advantage of that and are now making hundreds of thousands of dollars from taxpayer money, not necessarily for the good of the kids their schools are supposed to teach.
And then on the other side, you see someone like Arne Duncan, who just got tapped as the education secretary out of Chicago. And along with a few other folks in Chicago, including Johnny Rogers of Ariel Capital and a few other folks, actually came up with an interesting idea of how they could set aside schools and charter scenarios and actually succeeded. I mean, at what point are we going to get this right? And what do you think it's going to take to?
Well, I think as long as Arnie, I think I was reading a story the other day where he was telling people, just call me Arnie. But the tone has to be set there. And if he sets the right tone, I think we can start making those adjustments, down the pipeline. But the tone really has to be set by the guy at the top. And the tone before was, test scores, test scores, test scores. But I think he's going to be looking to do more than just test scores. And with that right kind of tone, it can really change the way things are done with education. But I don't know if it can be done in 4 years or 8 years, because there's so many hurdles that have to be jumped over before, complete change comes.
There's so many other items out there. Energy comes to mind, and a few other items out there. But
Yeah.
certainly, it speaks to a new brand of leadership that seems to be coming about. I mean, it's been said that we now have a new generation of leaders,
Oh,
including
absolutely.
President Obama, who's now 47, I think,
I
just this
believe
past
you're
August.
right.
And in this area, we even have new people coming along, like a gentleman named Kenyatta Johnson, a state rep, and also a state rep named Tony Payton, who's in
Payton.
his 30s. And then there's this really bright fellow who everybody's watching out there named Paul Johnson, who's beginning to do some things with a Brazilian Philadelphia kind of connection that's out there. This is really fascinating group of folks. What can be said about the young people that are leading our nation and state right now?
I think it's great. I think that for too long, we have relied on the old school way of, not the old school way, but we've relied on folks who've been in the trenches for a long time to kind of carry us forward. And what happens with that is you get used to doing things the same old way over and over and over again. Then you get people entrenched in power who don't want to change because they're very comfortable where they are. And any effort to change could mean they'll be put out of power or they'll lose some power that they have. So I think it's great that these young men and women have come up and been able to instill a sense of change and get away from the old way of doing things. And Kenyatta Johnson, I was really impressed by him. I spoke to him when I was on the editorial board at the Daily News, and we supported him for office. Bright young man, sharp, but he also knows the street. You know, so he kind of knew his way around the political world there in Philadelphia, which can be very, very tough. And Tony Payton's the same way. He managed to hold on to his seat, but he emphasizes education, which was a very good move. So I think it's great that these young folks are coming with new ideas, and they aren't afraid to buck the establishment. Indeed. And too often, bucking the establishment has meant punishment. Indeed. But now I think, as you see with President Obama, you can buck the establishment and really move forward.
Indeed. Including that young leadership, if you will, is Michael Nutter. Actually, a veteran political observer remarked about Mayor Nutter. If he lived in Chester County, he'd be a Republican. Any quick thoughts on Michael Nutter and the way he's governing Philadelphia right now?
I think that the thing that got Nutter, Michael Nutter, in the office was the fact that he couldn't be categorized as black or white, mm-hmm. or Democrat or Republican. He was speaking hard on police, making the police department stronger and cracking down on crime. I mean, that's not something you usually hear from a Democrat. And so what I found very interesting about Mr. Nutter is that he was able to blend what's the stereotype Republican and the stereotype Democrat into a mold and into an idea that was about all the people. I mean, even people in the neighborhood, we've been so inclined to be against any kind of increase in police presence and whatnot. But I think the reality is folks are tired. They're sick and tired of getting beat up and shot and having to be scared in their neighborhoods. They want a change. Mm-hmm. And it has nothing to do with party politics in terms of Democrat. They want to live life.
Sure.
They want to live life. And I think that's something that Nutter captured, and I think that's something President Obama captured as well.
Certainly.
So,
well, a couple of things real quick. Just as we come toward the end of the show, what are some of the things you would have the viewers look out for in 2009?
Well, I think that one of the things that our viewers can look out for is I think there is going to be a serious change in attitude in terms of this country. I think there's going to be a real serious change of attitude in terms of who we are. I think for a long time we've walked around with our heads down and frightened because we went from being of this really nice in terms of respected country to a country that's really hated in a lot of the world. And I believe that's going to turn around. I think it started already with President Obama's election. So I think that's something to look out for. I think that we mentioned education. I think that's going to take a while to come around, but I think a lot of people are going to be really focused on that. A lot of colleges and universities are going to start picking up the pace in terms of producing more teachers and increasing the sort of raising the bar for teachers who have to go out there. And I'm mentioning teachers a lot because I've started taking going after a master's in education at Cabrini. I feel that's sort of what my calling is, so I'm going to try to do that. So there are a lot of things to look for, and the danger of predicting is, you know, you can always be wrong. So we'll have to wait and see what happens.
Well, you've done well with us so far, and we really appreciate your time, Al, as
Thank
always.
Maurice.
Ladies and gentlemen, we greatly appreciate your time in viewing us today. I'm Maurice Goodman. This is Mr. Al Hunter, Jr., and you're watching Del Valle Now, and we thank you.